Following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 2nd Chapter, text number 24, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on November 4th, 1972, in Vrindavan, India.
पार्थिवाद दारुणो धूमस्तस्माद् अग्निस्त्रयीमय तमसस्तु रजस्तस्माद् सत्तं जद् ब्रह्मदत्। दिस इज ग्रेजुअल प्रोसेस ऑफ इवोल्यूशन। पार्थिवाद दारुण जस्ट लाइक रॉ वुड, देन व्हेन इट इज ड्राई then it is fit for igniting fire. Then when you ignite fire, first there is smoke, and after it is mature, the flames come out. And agni streamaya, when the flame is there, just like we generally perform fire sacrifice, unless the flame comes, we do not chant the mantra or pour the ghee and the grains, because that is the beginning of yajna. Straimaya. Strai means Vedic yajnas. So our point is to come to the platform of performing yajna. Yajna means Vishnu, the platform of satisfying Vishnu. This is the perfection of life. Dull brain, ignorance, just like animals. They are in the tamogun, ignorance. They cannot understand anything. So, gradually, they are promoted to the human form of life, rajogun. Generally, human form of life, rajogun, activity for creation. We can very well see animals, cats, dogs, cows, asses, and little civilized engaged in sense gratification in a different way, very active passion. So these two stages of life will not help us, because our aim is to come to the point of Brahma darshana, self-realization, aham brahmasmi. To remain karmis or remain animal-like life, no knowledge, simply eating, sleeping, mating, that's all. And little advancement means the same eating, sleeping, mating, but in a polished way. Mostly we find in the Western countries, they aim is animal propensities, but in a polished way. Suppose they live in very, very high skyscraper buildings, and the animals live in some cave, in some hole, in some nest. So, for living condition, improving the living condition, does not mean Brahma darshanam. Brahma darshan is another thing. Improving the living condition, improving the eating condition, improving the sex life condition, or improving the defending condition, just like human civilization, they are discovering so many lethal weapons, atomic bomb, so many things. So it is improving the defending condition. But modern civilization is in the opinion that if they can improve their material condition of eating, sleeping, mating and defending, that is advancement of civilization. But that is not advancement of civilization. Advancement of civilization means Brahma Darshana. That is advancement. Because so long we do not come to the platform of understanding that I am spirit soul, I am part and parcel of the Supreme Spirit, we are in the ignorance, in different forms. The example is given very nicely, just like raw wood, just from the trees, you cut the trees, it is raw. It is not immediately fit for burning, but when it is little dried, you can ignite fire. And igniting fire immediately, there is no flame, there is smoke. Then, after the smoke, there is flame. And that flame is required. So, this gradual process of evolution means one must come to the platform of understanding Brahma. Aham Brahmasmi, I am spirit soul and I am part and parcel of the Supreme Soul. This understanding one must come. So for that understanding, one has to come to the platform of goodness, Satagun. If one remains in the Rajagun and Tamagun, as we have explained, then we shall be entangled in this material world. We may get a different types of body. Even if we get the body of demigods, or European body, American body, as they are understood, very advanced. So not only European, American, but there are other improved condition of life in higher planetary system. They are all made of rajagun, rajastam. Tato rajastam bhava, kama lobhadasya. Because everywhere you will find the prominence of greediness and lust. Everywhere, even in the heavenly planet, the king of heaven, he is very, very much lusty. There are so many instances. He is very much fond of sex life. Indra. So, this will not help us. We must come to the platform of Satogun, goodness, the Brahminical stage. Then our life, our evolutionary process will be successful. Tamasastu rajastasmat saptam jat brahma dasana. Gradually, evolutionary process. I think in Darwin's theory there is no such conception of coming to the point of satogun, goodness. They do not know what it is, satogun. Simply they are studying the animal bones, that's all. But actually, perfection of evolutionary process is to come to the platform of satogun, brahminical stage. In other words, to become a brahmana is the topmost platform of advancement of civilization. Brahminical culture is the perfect advancement of civilization. That is mentioned here. So if one wants to come to that platform, then one has to accept the form of Vishnu, as we have already explained in the previous verse. Sriyangshi tatra khalu saptatano ninangasu. Sattvatan. Vishnu is the form of Satvagun. Brahma is the form of Rajagun. And Shiva, Lord Shiva, is the form of Tamagun. So actually, if we want our perfection of life, we will not be very much benefited by taking shelter of Lord Shiva or Lord Brahma or any other demigods. Other demigods, they are all subordinate to Lord Brahma and Shiva. All demigods are supposed, even great saintly rishis, they are also sons of Brahma, Rajagun. Lord Shiva is also one of the sons of Brahma. So, either to accept other demigods or even Lord Shiva or Lord Brahma will not help us, because we have to come to the platform of Satvagun. For that purpose, Sattvatano. Sattvatano means Vishnu. So we have to take shelter of Vishnu. In the Vedas, in the Rig Veda, it is said, Tad Vishnu Paramam Padam Sada Pashyanti Suraya. Vishnu Paramam Padam. Suraya, those who are advanced in civilization, Suraya, Sura and Asura. Asura means materialistic person, atheistic person, interested in sense gratification, that is called Asura. Nasura. And Sura means interested in advancement of spiritual life, that is called Sura. So, for the Asuras, the life is different. But for the Suras, their aim is Tad Vishnu Paramam Padam. Their aim of perfection is Vishnu Paramam Padam. The supreme abode of Vishnu or the Vaikuntha Lok. So those who are actually advanced in civilization, those who are in the platform of goodness, their aim is how to go back to home, back to God. That is their business. It is not that to take to religious life for some material gain. Dharmasya hi apavargas. Na artha arthaya upakalpate. We have discussed this verse. To become religious means to become free from material entanglements. Not that to take to religious life means to develop economic condition. Generally, people take to religious to make economic development very easily. Therefore, at the modern age, the educated public, they are not interested in religious life because they think that in primitive stage, the people were taking to religious life for economic development. Actually, that is the idea, because ordinarily people go to ask for bread in the church. Oh God, give us our daily bread. So modern advance in science people, they think, what is the use of asking bread in the church? Why not take to industry? That is their aim. In India, especially, this is the situation. The government is thinking that Indian people, being too much religiously inclined, they have fallen down economically. Therefore, these religious sentiments should be stopped completely. It is not encouraged. Here in Vrindavan, so many pilgrims, they come from all parts of India. Now all parts of world, they're coming. But it is kept in such unclean state to discourage people not to come here. That is the idea. So that people, educated people, modernized people may not come here. They do not want. That is the policy I am seeing. They are introducing in the Vrindavan area so many industrial things, so that the spiritual atmosphere is to be killed. That is the policy going on. Nobody, the temples are neglected. No, question of improvement. The whole idea is not to come here. Please do not come. They cannot say directly, but this is the idea going on. This is due to wrong direction of civilization. They do not know what is the aim of civilization. The aim of civilization is to understand Vishnu, the Supreme Personality of God. But they are missing the point. They are thinking motor tire civilization, very nice road and running motor car in 70-80 miles speed, that is civilization. Not to understand Vishnu. That is the difference between materialism and spiritualism. But we should not be misled by such conception of civilization. Our aim is different, and that is right different. I am spirit soul, you are spirit soul. Somehow or other I have been entangled with this material body, one after another. So I must get out of this entanglement and go back to home, back to Godhead, to Vishnu, and live there eternally, blissful life of knowledge. That is our aim. The materialistic person, they think these are all utopian thinking, conception, because they have no brain. They are no better than animals, polished animals, that's all. They cannot understand. In the tamogo, tamasa, tamasustu, tama and raja, these two qualities, material qualities are there. That in the Bhagavad Gita there is verse, karanam gunasanga asa sadasat janma jonishu. Karanam, why one is born in low great body, why one is born in high great body? What is the reason? The reason is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Karanam, karanam means reason. Karanam asa sanga, karanam guna sanga asya, because he is associating with one of the three modes of material nature. One is associating with satogun, one is associating with tamogun, one is associating with rajogun. So this is the reason. This is the reason that one is getting low-grade form of body or high-grade form of body. Karanam guna sanga asya sad asad janma jonishu. In another place it is also clearly stated, janti deva vrata devan pitrin janti kitri vrata. So karanam guna sanga asya. Therefore, the first-class civilization is that which associates with the modes of goodness, that is means brahminical civilization. Truthful, satta, sama, dhamma, titikya, arjava, jnanam, vijnanam, astikam, brahma, karma, samadhi. This is first class civilization. People must be truthful. They must be equiposed, not disturbed. Not being disturbed by different situations. They must learn how to control the senses. They must learn how to control the mind. samadhamat, they must be tolerant, titikha, arjava, they must be very simple, no duplicity, arjava, jnanam, they must know everything in full knowledge, vijnanam, apply the knowledge in practical life, astikam, they must believe in the Vedic injunctions, astika, that is called astika. The atheist and theist, the theist believe in the Vedic injunctions. Vedaishta sadvayaham eva, that is theist. Not that I believe in God, they must believe in the injunction of the Vedas. What is said in the Vedas, one must believe. That is called theist. As we have given several times the example, the Veda says the cow dung is pure. One who believes in that, he is theist. And one who does not believe in the words of the Vedas, they want to change, they want to misinterpret, interpolate, they are atheists. Bhagavad Gita, anyone misinterpreting, giving wrong interpretation or according to his concocted interpretation, they are atheists. Theist, he will believe all the words of Bhagavad Gita as it is. As Arjuna believed, sarvam etam vitangamanne jadavadasi kisha. My dear Krishna, whatever you are speaking, without any malinterpretation, without any change of word, I believe in it. This is theist understand. And not like the so-called rascal scholars. It is not like this, it is not like that. I think it is like this. These are all rascals. This is the process of civilization. Krishna consciousness means perfect civilization. Perfect advancement of civilization according to the direction of the Vedas. We do not concoct anything, any meaning. Just say, why you are reading this Srimad Bhagavatam? This is the beginning of understanding Srimad Bhagavatam. The professional readers, they immediately jump to the Rasa Leela of Krishna. They think that Bhagavatam means that Rasa Leela of Krishna. Because it appears like ordinary boys and girls, say they like it. No. This is the foundation of Bhagavata. The 9 cantos must be thoroughly read. Then one can understand what is Rasa Leela and what is Krishna. If one jumps at once to the platform of understanding Krishna's Rasa Leela or Vrindavan Leela, he'll be misled. He'll be misled. There's like so many rascals are interpreting Krishna in so many different ways. They are thinking Krishna as ordinary human being. So, when he acts like ordinary human being, they take him as ordinary human being. Therefore, one should not jump. One should learn Bhagavat, Srimad Bhagavatam, as recommended by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Secretary, Sarup Damodar, Bhagavata Gya Paro Bhagavata Sthani. One who is practical Bhagavat, one who knows what is Bhagavat, what is Bhagavan. Not from the professional reciters who are reading Bhagavat for belly's sake. Now they are reading Bhagavatam, and if they get more money, they can become a sweeper. Because their consideration in money. They will give up immediately reading of Bhagavatam. But my Guru Maharaj used to say that it is better to become a sweeper and honestly earn one's livelihood than to become a false Bhagavat reader for earning livelihood. Yes. Because they will mislead the whole public. Nobody will improve. And actually you have said that so many people, they are very much accustomed to attend the Bhagavad Saptaha, but they remain in the same darkness as they were. no improvement. That is not possible. So, therefore, Vasudeva has taken so much trouble to establish the Bhagavat life in 12 cantos. One has to go, one after another. Not jumping. Dasama Skanda, the 10th canto, is the face of Krishna. So, worshipping Krishna means one should offer tulasi on his lotus feet, first of all. Not jump over to the mouth or to the face. So the first and canto are the two lotus feet of Krishna. One should begin worshipping Bhagavatam, or the sound representation of Krishna, by worshipping the first canto and second canto. We are reading the first canto. We are just worshipping one lotus feet of Krishna, then the other, then the thighs. Gradually we have to rise to the face. The 10th canto is the face of Krishna. Don't jump over immediately. Read it, but try to understand from the very beginning. So, our aim of life should be to come to the platform of Satogun, goodness. Otherwise it is not possible. A person, there is Max Muller, in the depth of Rajagun and Tamagun, what he can write about Vedas and what he can understand Bhagavad, this is all nonsense. They are going to the translation of Max Muller, what he will understand Bhagavad and Vedas. He is in the Rajagun and Tamagun. Therefore, it is forbidden that without becoming a Brahmin, nobody should read the Vedic literature. It is forbidden. That I have already said several times. Without being a graduate, nobody should enter the law college. Similarly, Vedas, they are meant for Brahmanas, not for the Shudras, not for the Kshatriya also, they are, but under the instruction of the Brahman. So this is perfect civilization. One must know his own business. Everyone should not attempt to understand Vedic literature, remaining himself in the Rajana Stama Guna, Kama Loha Dayastari. There are many so-called sannyasis who went to your country. He was in fully in Rajana Stama Guna. He wanted to preach Vedanta. Therefore it was failure. Nobody can do so. So, it is very clearly stated, tamasastu rajastasma sattamajad brahmadas. No one must come to the platform of Satoko. Therefore we have got so many restrictions, just to keep him fit in the Satoko. No meat eating, no illicit sex, no intoxication, no gambling. If one indulges in these affairs, he cannot come to the platform of Satogun. Neither the things will be revealed to him. He'll remain in the darkness simply by academic scholarship. It is impossible to understand what is Vedas, what is Bhagavad Gita. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.